So you're about to light a show. You've read the script, you know what lights you're going to use. Now you have to choose which colours you're going to use. Choosing colour is arguably the most personal part of any lighting design. My favourite blue may well be your worst. So how do lighting designers go about choosing colour? Well, that's a tough question to answer, but here are some ideas that might help you to make your choice. Before we can start to use colour, we need to make sure that we understand how light works, and particularly how white light works. I'm sure you're all familiar with Newton's famous experiment where a beam of white light is refracted through a prism, and we see that beam is dispersed into red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. So from that experiment, we're able to deduce that white light is in fact made up of several different colours. Further work has enabled us to reduce the primary colours of light to red, green, and blue. By mixing these three colours together additively, you get white light. If you mix two primaries together, a secondary colour is created, these being cyan, magenta, and yellow. So, what is a filter actually doing? A filter absorbs portions of the spectrum and only allows the colour of that filter to pass through. So, when you put a filter in front of the light, you're effectively blocking out the parts of the spectrum that you do not want to see. A red filter will absorb the blue and green portions of the spectrum and only allow red light to pass through. Why do we see objects as having colour? If we shine white light at a red object, it will absorb the green and blue portions of the light spectrum and only reflect the red light back to us, so we see it as being red. If we project white light onto a yellow object, the blue portion of the spectrum is absorbed and the red and green light is reflected back to us, which our eyes see as yellow light. So now if we shine a green light at the same red object, it absorbs all the green light, and since there is no red to reflect, it appears to be black. Of course, we've been using very saturated colours, but the same principle applies even when you're using tints. But what does that mean to the lighting designer? Well, we use colour to manipulate things on stage to make them look as good as possible, or sometimes even change the way they look. When choosing a colour, we need to make sure that that filter includes light that falls within the spectrum of the objects we are lighting. How do you know whether the filter you've chosen contains the right colours? The transmission curve that Lee provides with each filter is a good guide. Let's look at two different shades of blue, a warm blue, 197, and a cold blue, 132. The cold blue blocks more of the red portion of the spectrum. Most colours have all parts of the spectrum present, albeit to varying degrees, which is why some blue filters can still work with red objects, and you will find that if you're careful with your selection, your colours will work well with the majority of elements that you're lighting. Don't be scared to experiment with colour. It's the part of lighting that I love the most. Thank you.